Let's meet the starting lineups. We will start tonight's duel at 170 pounds. For Glenbard East, they send out Jake Lewick versus the Redhawks, Eric Brentz. At 182 pounds, the Rams send out Matt Klubeck against the Redhawks, Louis Giovanetti. At 195 pounds, the Rams send out Amar Abdul versus the Redhawks, Ryan Bird. At 220 pounds, the Rams send out Shane Vincent against the Redhawks, Luke Rock. At 285 pounds, the Rams send out DeAndre Johnson versus the Redhawks, Joe Simon. At 106 pounds, the Rams send out Steven Nugent versus the Redhawks, Shuji Mizuguchi. At 113 pounds, the Rams send out Anthony Rogers versus the Redhawks, Derek Wilkie. At 120 pounds, the Rams send out Dayton Olsen versus the Redhawks, Yuki Mizuguchi. At 126 pounds, the Rams send out Jake Drew versus the Redhawks, Aiden Curley. At 132 pounds, Rams send out Zach Weed versus the Redhawks, Matt Chauvin. At 138 pounds, the Rams send out Josh Martin versus the Redhawks, Ben Williamson. At 145 pounds, Rams send out Dean Rosas versus the Redhawks, Andrew Cassiope. At 152 pounds, Rams send out Greg Wright versus the Redhawks, Hunter Stevens. And the final match of the night at 160 pounds, Rams send out Tyler Hulsick versus the Redhawks, John Needham. If you can now stand, face the flag at the south of the gym to your right for the national anthem.
Welcome to Naperville Central for this wrestling matchup between the Naperville Central Redhawks versus the Glenbard East Rams. Hello, I'm Mark Kim here for you today. We have a varsity matchup, and let's take a look at the lineup for Naperville Central. You take a look at the team, two big names to watch out for at 195 and 220, Ryan Berg and Luke Roth. both qualified for state last year. Although they didn't place, they certainly have a bright future this season. And let's take a look at the Glenbard East side for a second. And at 126, this team is led by Jake Drew, who's currently an honorable mention in the state rankings right now. Josh Martin also at 138, another honorable mention. And it's going to be interesting to see who they match up against. This meet's going to start soon. We'll see what happens. And their first match is going to be Eric Rentz versus Jake Lewick.
Let's wrestle!
2 minutes on the clock and begin some wrestling. Quick shot by Lewick, blocked off by Rentz as they go out of bounds. Clock stops at 1:39, still at 0-0, first period. And a shot by Lewick, defended by Rentz. We'll see if he can finish the shot. Lewick got a good leg, and he's gonna, we'll see if he can finish. He's getting close, and he's got the two right there, 2 points. Lewick wrestled last year at the same weight class of 170, placed sixth in the DVC. This is Rentz's first year on DVC. The JV2 tournament last year, he took first at the 160 weight division. We'll see, and he certainly had a good start off to the season, 1-2 record. And if he reached a minute in, Lewick leads 2-0. Goes out of bounds. Rentz will start at the bottom, and Lewick will start on top. Rentz says your decisions from last weekend when Naperville Central, now 1-2, lost to Batavia and Donner Grove South, but beat Chicago Lane Tech. Looks like Lewick's going for the ball and chain. Doesn't get it. Rentz gets his arm out. He's trying to base up. He can't get right now. He's got the base. Looks like he's going for a cradle. See if he's successful. And he's got the cradle. He's going to get some back points here. Let's see if he can get the pin. He's got 17 seconds. Rentz has got 17 seconds, and he is down. And that's going to be your 170 match by a score of 2-0 pinfall. Jake Lewick defeats Eric Rentz. And the time is going to be 1:46 on that pin. Up next, we got Louis Giovanetti. Giovanetti, a junior, this is his first year on varsity. He had a 1-2 record from the weekend. And he took second in the JV1 DVC conference last year. Central's got a lot of fresh faces. At the same time, some old faces in their newly revamped lineup. And that's going to be no points right there. As they'll reset in the middle. Klebeck's really working towards the head. And Louis finishing his shot. We'll see what he's got. Giovanetti, can he get it? Out of bounds, no count. Klebeck returning varsity also from this Glenbard East squad. He took sixth last year in the 182 DVC tournament. And as for Central that year, Luke Roth, who's currently at 220, he took second place. There's a struggle. We'll see. There might be a throw. And the throw goes to Klebeck. Giovanetti is trying to base up. Klebeck trying to finish. And things not looking so good for the Redhawks early on. And that's a pin right there for Matt Klebeck. It's going to be 1:22 pin for Matt Klebeck. And obviously here comes the strength of the Redhawk lineup at 195 and 220. Ryan Berg versus Almar Al Ghul. Berg was injured last week, didn't wrestle in that quad, but he took second in the DVC in his weight class last year. He was first in regionals and first in sectionals, so it's a record for Berg. As for Almar Ghul, this is his first year on varsity, so we'll see if he can take on this state qualifying Berg today. Al Ghul keeps on reaching for the leg. Berg's not letting him get it. Not much action. They've been in the same position for a while. They stand back up and back down. They're out of bounds. They'll reset in the middle. And there's Berg with the takedown right there. That's a simple double leg. That's as easy as it gets. And there's the escape point for Berg. He's got him to his back, and he's going to try to get that pin. Looks like he's losing control of Al Ghul. And he gets three back points, but time is... But he didn't get that pin. It is 7-1, and I'm joined by my partner, Connor Cesaretti, today. How are you doing, Connor?
Good, how are you, Mark?
Connor is a wrestler on the freshman team of this Naperville Central squad. He'll be helping me out today. It is 7-2 as Berg lets him back up. Only a couple seconds left. We'll see if he can get more points.
Berg's tying up with the other guy. He's turning around. 2 points. 2 points, Berg.
It is now 9-2 heading into the second period. This 195 match. Glenbard Central needs a pin. And there's Berg with that escape right there. Make that 10-2 right now.
Berg sprawling down, getting his going up.
Might be a throw. Didn't work out there. Berg gets the 2 points for another takedown. It's now 12-2. We could see a tech fall.
Berg circling. He's getting ready for his next shot. Mark, he needs to set up his shot here to get his two. There's his two.
And Berg just trying to let him back up, and he gets, and Al Ghul just falls. He's on his back. He's got a minute to leg this out, try to bridge out, or at least try to survive this. Looks like he'll be okay, but Berg will get three back points on this one. Berg still trying to finish that half Nelson. Doesn't get it, though.
Seventeen to three now, 14 points, and one more point, he gets a technical fall.
But as of right now, I'm not sure if Central wants that technical fall. They're down 12-0, and technical fall would only they'd want straight pins from Luke, from Roth and Berg.
Out of bounds now.
Al Ghul can't get out of Berg's grip.
He's going, can't exactly get it yet.
Al Ghul is up, and he takes him. Berg puts him back to the ground. As looks like to be end of the second period. Berg up 17-3 in this 195 bout right here. Central in an early hole, 12-0 in team points.
Now, Mark, if Berg gets an escape right here, he wins the match with a technical foul. He needs to get out of there just to get this win. Can't get pinned or anything.
I wouldn't imagine Berg getting pinned, especially in this lopsided matchup. And the way Berg has been dominating this match, he's going to get out pretty easily, I would imagine.
Yeah. Berg can't get stuck in that pin. It'd be too risky. And him with the reversal, 2 points. There's that technical fall.
And Berg will win in tech fall, 19-3. Central scores till 12-5 in team points. Here comes the other state qualifier from last year, Luke Roth. He took second in DVC, he took second in regionals, and he got third in sectionals, but that was good enough to get him to state. Although he didn't make quite a lot of noise at state, he's certainly a guy to watch out for this year.
Roth. Yeah. Roth made it to state for the past 2 years, lost his first match. He really needs to get in.
Roth and Berg both rated top 10 in their weight class for this year. It's going to be interesting to see where they go in the state tournament.
There he goes with the go behind. Almost got it.
They're spinning around so much it's making me dizzy.
Nothing yet. Brings him back. 2 points.
And looks like Shane Vincent almost got away from the grasp of Luke Roth, but he just couldn't get it. And Luke's going to let him back up. They're back in the neutral position. 1 point for Vincent. And Luke wants to take another shot. Try to snap him down. Didn't work out so well. You got to take a different approach.
Roth needs to get a shot in there. Needs to get more points. If he gets a pin in this, it will be 12-11.
The double leg take.
That's it. Nope. Oh,
and
there
he gets it,
is. It
right there. Just an interesting comparison between Roth and Berg. Berg, this is only his fourth year wrestling. He started wrestling his freshman year. Very impressive for a man who only picked up wrestling his freshman year. As for Roth, he's been in the club. He's been wrestling club since he was a little kid.
Yeah, in his grade year, he plays seventh in state in the IKWF.
It'll be interesting now that he's a senior to see if he'll place in state at this very competitive 220 weight class.
Yes. Taking his shots, lifting him up, and 2 points.
And sometimes just the most basic moves can get you the simplest. As a wrestler, you're first learned to for a double leg takedown or a single leg. Those two are the most simplest way to take takedowns, but Roth has shown that he has mastered that move very well.
Yes, yes.
As we begin the second period, Roth is up 6-2, and he's going to be down. He gets the escape easily, and it's 7-2 right now.
That was fast. He's a fast guy.
I mean, Roth also played linebacker for the football team this year. So I'd imagine he got to be pretty fast.
Yeah.
Same with Berg. Berg and Roth are both linebackers for the Central Varsity football team this year.
Good combination right there.
I'd be scared to get tackled by those two.
Yeah.
There's nothing right now.
Setting up the shots. Really needs to beat on that head more. Set up his shots, get that kid confused.
That was a bad shot right there by Vincent. Oh. We're already a minute into the second period so far. No shots.
But Roth is winning 7-2.
If I were Vincent, I would start getting aggressive here because things aren't looking too good for this guy.
Looks like Roth is trying to get the pass by, or trying to get the, whatever it's called.
Duck under?
No, it's, nope, there's his double.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. He's got another takedown via two legs, so he's got to keep going to that. Looks like Vincent can't do anything about it. We're going to see if Roth can get this pin. He's got 20 seconds to do it.
He needs to hold this. He really needs to start going for pinning combinations like the Mills half or half Nelson's. He's trying to get...
Personally, I love the power half. It's a strong move. He puts the pain to him.
Yeah.
It is now 9-2 heading into this third period. Vincent's going to go neutral. And Vincent's got to watch out for that vicious Roth. And Central would love a pin right now. They are down 12-5 in team point. As of right now, Roth would only get them a decision, which would only be 3 points and make it 12-8.
Roth really needs to watch out for that hip toss. The kid keeps going to it, but he keeps working his way out.
This is the final gambit for anyone that's basically down big. And you can see Vincent going for it. It's 9-2. And he's not going to get a lot of takedowns the way he's been wrestling. So he's going for that hip toss for this next minute and 20 seconds. Roth needs to take a shot now. See if he can try to get that pin or at least a major decision before this match is over.
He needs to get out of that lock. Right there, he's trying to get him over.
Another double leg takedown. Can he finish?
Out of bounds.
He's got a shot on Roth. He's still hanging on to that leg for dear life. It's no points yet. And and there's Vincent with 2 points.
Now it's 9-4. Roth's still up on bottom.
He's couldn't call for stalling. Potentially dangerous move by Vincent. That's 1 point for Roth. As he'll stay down, 10 seconds left. Roth would need an escape. And there's an injury timeout. Looks like it's Roth. It might be blood. But going back, if Roth gets an escape, it would be major decision. 4 points, it'd be and that would set up Joey Sala to tie it if he just wins by decision.
Yeah. We really need Luke to step up here, try to get a pin or the major decision. If we get those...
For the record, it's a match, not a game.
Well, the team... Yeah, the team match, okay.
It's okay, I'm just messing with you.
Now, Luke Roth down.
Looks like so far on top. You'll see if Roth can break through the grip.
Roth is going for the reversal. Couldn't get it. Oh, there it is.
And he's out, and there
escape.
We go. It's 11-4. And another shot. Will
double
he finish?
Leg.
He's got to try to suck him back in. That's 2 points for Roth. 13-4, 9 seconds left.
There's that major decision right there.
Let's see if he can nation with 9 seconds left by Roth. Highly doubt it, but hey, I've seen crazier things. And that's 1 point escape for Vincent. And that will be your match, 13-5. Luke Roth wins, major decision. Team score now 12-9. With Glenbard still in the lead as we head into the heavyweight bout between Joe Sala and DeAndre Johnson.
4 points for the team, now it's 12-9.
And we'll see Joey Sala and DeAndre Varsity wrestlers. Information on Sala, he got third in the JV1 DVC conference last year. at that heavyweight division.
I always like watching these heavyweights.
As for the heavyweights, it's basically just a lot of throwing and a lot of shoving compared to the lower weights, where it's a lot of technique, speed, and the middle weights wins a lot of strength.
With the heavyweights, it's like two big like to me.
They certainly have a lot more technique than just two balls being thrown at each other. Nothing's happened so far with
it's hand fighting.
40 seconds left. 4 minutes pass it. 40 seconds passing. You're not a minute 15 left on the clock. You gotta see a shot from at least one of these guys, or maybe a throw.
Oh, up on the single right there.
Johnson going for the finish. He trips him up.
Oh,
and Sala flips him over. Great move by Big Joe Sala. He's got that chicken wing right there.
He's trying to get the wrist. He needs to get the wrist to get that chicken wing.
For Big Joe, he's 1-2 on the season. A pin, so we'll see if he can get add another pin to his resume.
Oh.
He nearly tried going for the cradle.
Bounds.
Looks like they're
out of bounds right there.
For reversal. Close call. I wasn't sure if I'd call it like that, but you know, it could go either way. But my, what a great move by Joe Sala. Looked like a bad situation to point for him. He's going to try getting out from the grip of Johnson.
Now Joe Sala has to work not getting pinned or on his back at all.
His back, a very risky move. Johnson just can't seem to finish him off. And she gets the escape point. And that'll be the end of the first period. Joe Sala up 3-2 in a very exciting period. Johnson had the choice from the coin flip, and he'll choose down. Sala will be up. Can break him down and go for the pin. And Sala joined the wrestling team last year, actually. And now
really?
He's on varsity, yeah.
He's doing pretty well.
For Johnson, we'll see more action in the neutral position.
Johnson's going for the throw. He can't exactly get it. Oh, there it is.
As that looking goes, no. Got it.
No.
And Johnson
neutral.
Gets out. And the thing about this match is that Sala and Johnson are basically handing each other up. Neither of them can finish.
Looks like a lot with the Glenbard East wrestlers that they're going for hip tosses and throws.
And basically that's a get. Is either move. And there's Sala, and he gets 2 points on that spin toss. I don't know exactly what to call it. Oh, whatever works for him, that's 2 points. Looks like Sala is trying to work that power half.
If he wants to put in that power half, he needs to get in the side that he's putting it in.
And he's like a weak power half right there. It's called a power half for a reason. Looks like
Going
for a cradle.
No.
That's a risky move,
not
a very good idea. Luckily, he caught that. Approaching 30 seconds left in the second period. Sala up 5-3.
Sala needs to put in his half right now. He has an opportunity right there.
He's going for that chicken wing. He's trying to turn him over. He's got 20 seconds left to do it in this position.
Oh.
Bad idea. And there's Sala on that reversal right here. His official points is on his back to stay off of it. And a very nice bridge by Joe Sala. And that's
time.
3 back points for DeAndre Johnson. He is up 8-5. And a very exciting heavyweight match to be indeed. And I would and Sala's going to go down. Like try to escape, get out, and get that takedown to tie the match up at 8. Or even better, try to get a reversal and some back points. He's basing up. Johnson just can't finish. That's 1 point for Sala at 6-8. And that was a penalty on Johnson.
Get
up, Joey! Come on, Joey!
And there's Sala. He's going to try to get, he needs to get out now. He's certainly in a bad position. He needs a reversal to tie it. And if you want to win, what's your Sala a takedown?
Sala needs to get his escape. He gets that.
And there's the near escape by Sala.
Oh,
Johnson's still clinging onto that leg for dear life. We'll see if he can finish. He's going for that sprawl. He's trying to break the leg. He's got to show a point for Sala. And here, locked up. We're going to see a throw, ladies and gentlemen. And no, we're not. It is 7-8. And it does not get up, Connor. The crowd is on their feet.
It's a big match for us. We need
Sala's got to get 5 seconds to do so. He looks fatigued. He needs to take a shot now.
Both of these wrestlers are dead tired. But Sala get his shots in.
30 seconds left. Time is running out for Joe Sala. He's got 20 seconds now. The clock is not his friend, and neither is his body shape, because he looks fatigued. He needs to throw. He needs a thing.
10 seconds left. He needs this. Go, Joe. That looks like it's the end of the match. DeAndre Johnson gets that match for them. But only 3 points on team.
And that was a great match to watch, to say the least. But kind of disappointed in Joe Sala. He had a good full minute. And he just stood there and watched things happen.
Yeah, he really needed to get in there. Now we're at the lightweights. The 106. And Tsuji Mizuguchi, he's a friend.
He's wrestled a lot of club. He's the brother of Yuki Mizuguchi.
He's in the cradle position. He gets out, though.
And the escape.
Now, Tsuji's a good wrestler. He's in there on the single.
He's a
get
freshman.
There around.
There's a potentially dangerous call right there. And so Steven Wynn, the wrestler from Glenbard East, he is an injury fill-in for Carlos Fuentes, who is going to be injured for quite a while. He's ranked 11th in the state, and he's a junior, and he got injured last weekend. And here comes Wynn as a replacement, and it looks like things are going to look pretty good. He has one major decision on the season with a 1-2 record.
Now wrestling Varsity for...
It's quite a tough thing to do. It's quite an experience, and only a couple of Redhawks have had the opportunity to do so. Looking at the roster, Derek Wilkie, he wrestled 106 last year. He wrestled 126 last year.
Oh. Tsuji's around. He's almost got the...
And Tsuji's just going to pop his head out there, and he might be okay. He's looking to get the back, and he won't. He's going to get 2 points for a three. I would imagine he learned things from his brother, who's the 120 starter.
Taking back down. Tsuji's trying to go for the tilt right there, looks like.
Trying to get some of those easy back points. Pretty risky move, as things can turn really badly.
Oh, putting in the legs. Has in both of his legs.
And he's got a ride in there. Got 26 seconds left in this first period. Mizuguchi down 4-3 to win.
To break this kid down with putting the legs in his legs, he really needs to put a lot of back pressure on and get the other wrestler down.
We got 10 seconds left. Do anything with this position. Doesn't look like we can. We'll probably head into the second period like this. Looks like there's not going to be any points from that one. It's quite close, though. We'll see what happens in the second period. Mizuguchi will be down, be up. Mizuguchi's got to get out in order to tie this match up at 4-4.
Tsuji's got the... trying to work it down there. Working his way around, Tsuji's almost getting the reversal.
right now. It just seemed to be locked in the same position.
Oh,
there's a stalemate call. They'll reset.
Come on, Gigi.
Got to get out. You can't let Wynn ride him for the entire period, or else it'll be a wasted call.
These 106 pounders look like they like to put the legs in.
They don't have a lot of strength, so they got to use a lot of crafty technique to try to get their points in. Taguchi's got to do something. He's been locked in that same position for the entire period, basically, actually.
Oh.
And he might be going somewhere. We'll see. We'll see.
Tsuji's on top.
And there's the reversal points right there.
He's got Tsuji Mizuguchi. Oh, working for the tilt. He's putting in his legs.
Why not just go for the pin?
That's pretty tough with this guy, it looks like.
And there's another reversal. Will it be?
Off his back.
And he's still got control. He's got 6 minutes to hold it down.
1-0. That's time. Second period.
Credits to Tsuji. Nearly got called for the reversal. Managed to keep enough control to not get that called on him.
Tsuji starting on top. Tilt.
He's got the arm. He's not doing much with it, though. All shown. If he escapes, it's a tie. He just can't let the reversal happen, at least.
Oh, puts in half. Almost got it. Half. Mills half.
He might be getting out.
Oh.
And he's let go. And here we go. 3 minutes. It's going for that single leg. Can he finish?
Oh boy. He's in the splatel. Tsuji needs.
And that's 2 points.
2 back points for Glenbard East. And the 2 points for the takedown.
And Mizuguchi's got to get back points of his own. It is 9-7, Wynn in the lead.
For that cradle. He's almost got it. Let's go.
And that's for Wynn.
Two points for Mizuguchi. Getting the back points.
It's an exciting tilt. He just needs two. He needs to lift the head.
And he has.
Looks like he's got three back points. And this could be the match. Mizuguchi takes the 12-11 lead. He just can't mess this up right here.
Wins for Naperville Central.
And a great win for Naperville Central. And I thought Wynn had the early control. Like his brother, Tsuji Mizuguchi defies all odds. A lot of gamble moves, but he gets the win somehow.
And that's pretty impressive. That takes a lot of courage to get out there on the varsity mat.
Great job.
Now Derek Wilkie up against Afan Rogers.
It's Anferni Rogers, actually.
Anferni Rogers.
Taking the quick shot.
Oh, he's in there with the double.
Looks like it's going to be, Rogers has got 2 points. And there you go, there's the takedown.
There's an escape for Wilkie.
And he's still got that wizard, but doesn't count. Wilkie down early. Wilkie, he is currently 3-0. All three of his wins pinned, as he's been the early team leader.
Impressive season as a freshman on the varsity team. 106 pounds.
He was at Tsuji Mizuguchi's spot. And now he's moving up to 113. And it's going to be real interesting to see what happens to the lineup. After Lee, who is out right now, comes back into the lineup. And there's 2 points for Wilkie.
He's going for the cradle. Almost has it.
This is not looking good. There's a reversal for and Farney Rogers. That name's tough to pronounce, that's for sure.
Yeah. Period. Glenbard East 6-4.
As for the team score, Naperville Central at 12. The team would really like Wilkie to come away with this win. He is down 6-4.
Shin on Rogers with his hand on Wilkie's elbow.
There's a to approach the body of Wilkie. He went a little too fast. He went one step too far. And there went the penalty. Looks like as he continues to ride Wilkie.
Going for the Mills half, Rogers loses it against Wilkie.
Very effective move, to say the least. Trust me about
Wilkie getting his hand control, locked hands on Rogers.
And he saw Porter on the side.
There have been a lot of locked hands today for Glenbard East. During the freshman match, there were, during the freshman, at least three locked hand calls, and most of them the referees.
I remember my first match in junior high. I was called for a locked hand, which costed me the match. You know what? That stuff happened. And there's 2 points for Rogers, reversal. And that's going to be a Wilkie's got to get out.
Rogers going for that cross face. Now he has the Wilkie needs to snap that handlock. He gets out of it. No back points.
And he's on his back. That can't be good.
Rogers is getting back.
Wilkie's got to get out. He's got 24 seconds to stick it out there. It might be a pin.
No.
It's looking close.
Oh.
3 back points for Rogers.
Score is now 11-8, Rogers.
Oh, he's got 3 points of reserve. His back points have not been called yet.
There's his 3 back points.
11-8.
In order for Rogers to get those 3 back points earlier than he did, he had to let go of that.
And they're neutral. Oh, God, let him back up and take another shot.
Wilkie on the leg, gets his double in.
He's hanging on to that leg for dear life, that's for sure.
Nod scramble right there. Should be, nope.
There's nothing, there's 2 points for Rogers.
Oh.
Things not looking off more. Wilkie. As this might be his first loss of the season.
Can't say that yet.
It ain't over until the fat lady sings.
Wilkie's up on top, reversal, 2 points.
And now he's got to get 3 back points. He's got a minute to do so.
Wilkie has his legs in.
He's riding a little too high.
Get Rogers back on the mat. Can't get his shoulder blades quite. Potential dangerous.
Anybody get him to his back? No. Great job back. Wilkie's got to get a finishing move. He's got 30 seconds to do so. The clock is not his friend.
He needs to break Rogers down.
He's got to get into quick time mode. 15 seconds now, down 13-10. He needs some back points.
Oh,
and there you have it. That's a 15-10 win. beating Derek Wilkie. Score is now 18-12.
Now we have Yuki Mizuguchi up, Tsuji Mizuguchi's brother.
He'll be wrestling Dayton. She took first in the JV1 conference tournament last year. That's Rolson. He wrestled Varsity. That'd be quite a good match, to say the least.
Fourth in DVC?
Yes, fourth in DVC. He was in the same class as last year from Central Alumni. Taking early control. But the thing with Yuki Mizuguchi is that you count him. I remember when I was on the team, he was nicknamed Kamikaze and Sushi Roll. Gambling moves, and often it pays off for him.
Yuki's trying to break Drew down. Oh.
And Olsen, control early. He's going to spin around. Nearly gets 2 points. Doesn't. Tries going for a... And he's got that single leg. Mizuguchi hanging on for...
Olsen has the 2 points for the takedown. 4-1, Olsen.
Looks like Olsen wants to go. Master Mizuguchi, he is also 3-0 on the season with three pins. Then again, two of his wins were forfeits. Hey, wins are wins.
Yeah. Oh, hip toss, can't exactly get it. You're trying to do a Granby right there.
And it's 6-2. Olsen in the early lead with 21.5 seconds left in the first period. Naperville Central 18-12.
Caution call called on Olsen. Didn't put his hand full elbow. Mizuguchi. Oh, he's brought back down very hard, very hard.
He's slow to get up. This might be bad for him.
There was a call, aggressive call called on Olsen.
That's going to be a problem. Not feeling so good. I hope to God this is not a concussion. Actually, if he had a concussion, wouldn't this count for a win? Because, I mean, his move was considered dangerous, and he got a point there.
All depends.
But, hey, I haven't been wrestling since sophomore year, so.
So far on the NCHS wrestling team, there have been 4 concussions. In the last 3 years, there haven't been any recorded concussions. So that tells you that.
You were one of them, weren't you, Cesaretti?
Yeah, I was. Yeah, I was out for a week.
Back again.
Yeah.
You had a nice win today.
Yeah, thank you. Takedown.
And Central has got a young. At 106, they have Mizuguchi, the freshman. Wilkie, he's at wrestled 2 years. He's at 113. Mizuguchi at 120. This is his first year on varsity. At 126 coming up, we have Aiden Curley. 0-3 record. 132, we got Matt Choback. And he's gone brought up to the varsity level. And then comes a little bit more, Ben Williamson, 45, Andrew Cassiope. This is his first year on varsity. He wrestled for the Disney duels.
For the freestyle team?
Yes. He's been wrestling since last year. And 160, this is going to be John Needham's first year on varsity. Young group of wrestlers. And we'll see what they can do.
Yeah.
That Glenbard's group of wrestlers have done a much better job. That's another 2 points.
Yeah. Dayton Olsen is playing the takedown, let him up game.
Not this time. He's letting him.
Oh. There's the grab. Oh, almost gets it. Not exactly.
Teammates nicknamed that the sushi. Nothing doing as we ticked up the clock. 5 seconds left. Mizuguchi trying to... And it won't go. It's out of bounds. He's got 0.6 seconds left, and you're going to probably see 12-5. Heading into the third period, unless Mizuguchi can be really fast and get out for a second. But that's going to be 12-5. Mizuguchi is down against Dayton Olsen, like here in the DVC. And it shows that he's an experienced guy. He knows. not going to let Mizuguchi get easy points. As he starts down,
Yuki really needs to get that hand control right at the beginning. Get out and start his takedowns. Get in control of the match. That's what he needs to do.
Victory formation for Mizuguchi, trying to go for that hip toss. Time, he could turn things around. He's going to try throwing him. He's trying to go for the victory.
Going for the hip toss right there.
And there he goes.
Oh.
No.
Lost the arm.
He had it, and it's gone. It's close.
Yuki really can't give up right here.
Potentially dangerous call. 1 point for Mizuguchi. Olsen's just going to let Mizuguchi up. It is now 14. Olsen in the lead. Mizuguchi not faring so well in this match. Mizuguchi. And he's
still
trying
neutral
to get out. He's got 12 seconds left. He doesn't want to give up the match.
Seconds left.
Survive, and this match will only become 3 points for Glenbard. There you go.
That's the end of the match. 14-8. Bringing up 3 points for his team.
Things aren't looking so good for this Redhawk squad as it brings up 86 starter for Naperville Central versus Jake Drew of Glenbard East. He's an honorable mention. He's certainly doing something right. He took fourth in the 106 at DVC. Wilkie taking sixth that year as well. This Drew versus Curly match can do. Maybe Drew had a lot of muscle because he certainly jumped up a There's a shot.
Going for the high crotch. Transitioning to a double leg.
And it's not like Glenbard East is a very easy team to wrestle. They are ranked 25th in the state.
And out of bounds, neutral. No points yet.
Continuing my thought, you can see with the way that they've been wrestling Central today.
Curly's in a bad position. He needs to get out.
So trying to get that leg.
Oh, he needs to get out. Oh.
He's turning
opposition
around.
Opposition scramble. 2 points. Putting in the legs, trying to break Curly down. 2 points. With his tilt.
As for Curly, he's been matches. But he took first in the JV-DVC last. Central having a very good JV-1 team.
2 points for Drew.
Not necessarily that level, and obviously so. As we'll end the first period, Jake Drew with a... And I was talking to Curly on the sidelines, and he joked that he got pinned in the first period last year. Mm. Curly told me, jokingly saying, than Wilkie. So looks like he certainly has. He survived that first period. It's a very experienced.
He's trying to break him down now. And Drew Curly takes him back down, but Drew lands on top. Drew has control. He's getting
out. Nothing to do in position.
Curly needs hand control. That's for sure.
He needs points.
Hand control leads the points. That's the way it goes. go out of bounds. Drew's on top.
There's Curly on bottom. Short of progress.
Something can't get called for stalling.
We've basically been in the same situation for the past period.
Drew getting in his tilt right there. Back points.
Struggle so far. Naperville Central lower weights.
From the 285 to the 106,
Joe Sala and shooting Central side. And DeAndre Johnson and Steven Wynn.
Definitely.
Certainly has been the same type of energy in this gym ever since.
Yeah. These are tough matches to go with. From when I was younger, they had they only had 1 minute and 30 second periods. Now it's 2 minutes, 6 minutes. Very long, very tough.
It's quite the test of endurance, test of heart, test of mind. Wrestling is more than just a physical.
It's a lot of mental too. A lot before the match.
We both known. We both wrestled.
Yeah.
Are over.
Well, you know, you can always come back.
Not at this point. I'm a senior. Just saying.
Yeah.
And there goes Curly. He stays down. He can't do anything. And for Curly, I would imagine the only thing he wants to do is...
Yeah, you can definitely tell that. He has a lot of control on the top. It's very good. No doubt about it.
As for Curly, he hasn't had the greatest start to the season. Lucky to score right now. If things stay as the way they are, Curly will end up...
It's okay. Some seasons start like that. Slow, but they get fast, and they'll get exciting.
I've seen wrestlers that... Same time, there's pressure coming from the JV1 level. With Anthony, very good wrestler. I've wrestled him a couple times.
Yeah.
Seconds left. All Curly has to do is not get pinned, and he'll run away from this... Next, we'll have Matt Chobak versus.
Now, this is Matt Chobak's first start on varsity, on JV.
And he's a sophomore, right?
Yeah, he's a sophomore. Like, he got 3 pins so far, 3 wins.
He's certainly been dominating on the JV. JV domination doesn't exactly transfer over on the varsity level.
Yeah. He needs to show that he can be on varsity and really wrestle.
And this match, starting with wrestlers immediately getting at it. A lot of speed, a lot of technique, hitting that leg. 6 in the 132 weight class last year at DVC. So Weedy's got that experience over Chobak, as this is Chobak's first
down for Weedy.
Certainly missed by Naperville Central, as at 132 there was Kirk Cherup from last year.
We lost a lot of seniors last year.
Tom Stevens Bland. The list can go on and on. Needless, Central is trying to live without him.
And we can do it. We have the team. We can definitely adapt to it. And there's the... Oh! And there's the... Almost. He doesn't exactly get it. Points right now.
Well, I mean, he doesn't seem certainly to be on... But I think before he was on his back, and I thought he'd get some points. There's 2 points... Great job by Chobak, has certainly given some pressure to Zach Weedy. Did Chobak fair in IKWF, I wrestled in junior high as well, club.
Yeah, he did. He was pretty good.
Did he qualify for state?
No, not back in IKWF. That's what happens. And you just improve and you get better. And that's what Matt Chobak has been doing.
Reversal by Weedy. And now he'll be down 4-2, period. And a very equal, the first close match in a while. 21-26, easy domination for Glenbard East team.
Cut. This Glenbard East questions and just being crazy about that.
Certainly don't have an effect because they've certainly been effective. Chobak on his back. He's against him. He's trying to get out. He's bridging out.
You can tell Chobak does not want to get Varsity start.
Oh, I don't think anyone wants to get pinned at all, ever.
Yeah.
There's Chobak. It's a nice single leg takedown. Nets two. Hook Weedy to his back.
Oh, he's high. Chobak is high.
As we've reached them down to the one mid, Chobak basically staring where he is. He might be a little.
If he wants to stay in control, he needs back and go for those turn back points.
He's got 22 seconds left in him. He's got to think of some combination. He's nothing really going. And that now, he was right a little high there. Oh, last second reversal. That's not good. Reach the third period, 6-4. There'd be some injury.
Oh, this is a very exciting night for Central, our first year.
Period. Chobak down 6-4. And this Vargy been a very good fourth between these two wrestlers. And Central's got to get some 18 points. As of right now, they've only got three weight classes. So looks like this match might be over.
Choke position.
Don't get so quick. Come on. Wrestle. Come on.
Taken down. There's Chobak. Taken down by Weedy. Things not looking so hot for the sophomore. We got a minute 40 left in the third period. Anticipate the biggest match of the night, Josh Martin versus Ben Williams. I was on that match after this match. And one, nothing really going for Weedy or Chobak. Chobak's got to act fast. He can avoid a major decision to make this less humiliating.
Yeah.
My math says that Central is going to lose this match.
It can happen. We really need to step up and get some pins. Get those team.
Again, if you look at DVC results last year, Glenbard East beat Central last year 40. But at DVC, Central plays second. Central and the Central went to dual team state after beating Maine West in a dual match to send the team to Bloomington. Looks like there's a little dispute with the refs. A little bit of a dispute there. Looks like it's going to be solved with a minute 11 seconds left. This match looks like it's probably over. But that lady sings, like I've said, probably for the second time so far in this broadcast.
So Chobak. Weez is going for the cradle. Can't Chobak on his back.
Chobak back. He gets out, and he's going to go for his own move. He's here for the win.
And there's the reversal for Chobak.
50 seconds left to pull out an improbable win. If he gets a pin, win the match. Other than that, it's a stalling call right now. He's got 37 seconds left in this match.
Mills half.
He's got 27 seconds left.
Anything.
I'm surprised he hasn't been called for stalling yet. It's been just there on his belly.
He wants to stay in the lead. That's what he wants to do.
there's a stalling call. One point for Choback. And it'll be a 12-7 win for Zach A. At least it isn't a major decision.
Yeah. It was a good first match for...
Things can only go up from here, that's for sure.
Yeah.
And here we go, the biggest match of the night right here. Here with Ben Martin. They both compete at the 126 weight class. Williamson currently 3-0 with two pins to his name. As for last year, they both weight division. Martin was fourth, but Williamson beat Martin too, so looks like this match is certainly going to be a close one. Williamson's here. There'll be no takedown. It'll be 1 point for Martin. And Watts on this team looking good for the future as he was as a freshman. He's a sophomore right now. Programs most recently John Williamson, who graduated 2 years.
Yeah. Oh, and there's Ben.
And there's Williamson. He getting him to his back. Couldn't quite get it though.
Ben's 2-1.
And there's 2 points for Martin.
Martin
on the reverse. And what did I tell you? It was going to be a good match, right?
Two very experienced and good wrestlers. In eighth grade, Ben Williamson made it to IKWF state, almost placing. Didn't quite make it, though.
He was in eighth grade, and Williamson was in sixth grade, working out at the team, even though he couldn't wrestle. Me run for my money, that's for sure.
Yeah.
That was my first year wrestling. Them right before I quit my sophomore year. And he dominated me. Big things coming out of this kid.
Yes.
Williamson will defer. On. He is up 3-2 to Ben Williamson. Williamson was asking for his coach to go neutral. Fight it down there.
Ride him out. Putting in the leg. Mark really trying to get that leg out because he knows Ben can out of moves from there.
Oh no, this end. Martin's got that leg, and that's going to be, that's 2 points reversal for Josh Martin.
Martin working that power half. Now he's trying to suck Ben.
With the way Williamson has wrestled so far.
He knows Williamson.
So can I. I know he can do a lot better than he's been wrestling. But then again, this is a close match. Both very good wrestlers. It's a call for stalling. No points will go on the board, though.
Ben needs the control and get out of there so he can generate his double.
It's a caution on Martin. Glenbard is not happy. And then against Martin. And he gets it right that time. Left. Williamson is reaching for the head. And the stalling called on William. He's got to get out. He's getting pretty close. He's just got to break out. He's standing there with his hands wide open. I don't know what he's doing.
I think Ben that Martin had locked hands.
Yeah. And it's now 5-2. Josh Martin here with the 5-2 lead.
Starting the Ben really needs to get his set up and get his.
Pull your head under. didn't exactly work out there.
Working their way back up. Ben needs to get his underhook. Still neutral.
Oh, by Mark.
2 points.
Not exactly a great, the best match I've seen from Williamson. There's now 53 seconds left. William Martin, this third period. The team is down 35-12, their best meet. In fact, this is probably their worst.
This is tough. It's a good school at wrestling.
The reason why they're ranked 25th in the state.
Yeah. Coach Porter calling for locked hand. He's exposing his back.
Looking very confused, that is. Looks like
Williamson
he tapped out.
Is tapping out. What?
Williamson looks like he's down and injured. Things not looking so good for Williamson. Is mad.
Getting looked at by the trainer.
Not happy.
There are a lot of not called moves in there by Martin.
Porter not happy at all. I think that it looks like they took down a team point there. Porter for unsportsmanlike conduct.
The refs really need, in my opinion.
Then again, we're from Central. What I saw a lot from that match was a lot of non-calling Martin's way. Call me biased or not, I saw it all. Right now, we got this, got a match right here. Dean Ross is from Glenbard East versus Andrew Cat.
Andrew Cassiope looking for that front, get it, trying to go for the go behind. For that cradle. 2 points for Andrew Cassiope.
Cassiope, he has a one. He got two. He got major against him, and he has a decision.
And Lombard East. Now the score, Andrew Cassiope against. With 21 seconds left in the first period.
Cassiope having the early 2-1 lead. Right,
and
there's
points.
2 points right there.
Andrew Cassiope.
That's the end of the period right now. Certainly a bright spot for the Central. Rosas will choose up. Down.
Caution call.
Looks like Lombardi's got to work on that in the practice room.
Yeah. Now with our center, for all the flips, we get, and that's what our team's been doing today.
And there's a Glenbard East. Finally.
Yeah. Finally locked hands.
There's a quick shot. Ross is not successful, and there's Cassiope. He's trying to break him down. Points for Andrew Cassiope. Cassiope took first and is one from JV1 DVC. Like I said, Naperville Central could be one squad.
Now, Cassiope digging Rosas for the getting the cradle. Oh, and there it is. And he pins him. Cassiope pins
Rosas.
Rosas, and that gained 6 points for the Central team.
2 minutes 46. The time as we head into one of our last matches, you got 52 and 6. Hunter Stevens, he was faced off against Greg Wright.
Now earlier today, Hunter Stevens had trying to cut weight before the match. See, now made it.
Thank God he made it.
Yeah.
It'd be more for their weight. Looks like it's a very active Wright and Stevens, and Stevens gets Wright.
That's for sure.
Nothing. Stevens
putting Wright up points.
And as things look, Stevens, he's known for a lot of throws himself. And he gets 3 back, manages to get off of his back. He's working again. We'll see what he can do. It's a potentially dangerous call. Stevens up 5-0 his first period. He tries rolling around. There's another throw. We'll see what happens.
Uses the his control. Top.
Great move by Stevens. Situation. When any potentially dangerous. I'm not a loser or anything. He could have got it put on his back that time. Once again, there's a reversal.
Scoring his first 2 points of the match. Now Wright's working that. Doesn't exactly, definitely got Stevens.
10 seconds left, 3 seconds left in the period. And Stevens gets him on his back. Reversal, 2 points for end it. Buzzer beater move. And is now Stevens continuing to dominate.
Period for Hunter Stevens.
Well, Stevens up 7-2 against Wright. Losing the team match. They're down 32-17. Nearly getting this guy on his back, getting right on his back.
2 points for Stevens. Getting back points. There's his back points.
It's like he's got him right there. There's the pin. And there's been 2 for Naperville Central. With Cassio, Stevens, both with pins. And here comes the Needham versus Tyler Los. Central now only down 32-23. There's no way they're going to win this meet, but let's out as the pit. Maybe Needham would add to the pin brigade that's been going on so far.
Very strong guy. He's fast, too. This is a very interesting match.
This is the type of guy you don't want to challenge in an arm. His brother, Cam, was on 4 years ago. At maybe, I think, a weight class lower. I think he And this is Losik's first stint on varsity. Having a little bit of varsity time last year, but not.
A lot of hand fighting. A lot of. They really need to get something started.
You want to see some action. You want to see some takedown. You want to see something. We don't want to look at 2 minutes of hand. You
know, something that would be really nice is us winning.
We get everything we want.
Yeah. John Needham.
More hand fighting. First period, 0-0.
John could work a carry right now, fireman's carry, very well. Getting inside hand control. going out of bounds.
So close. Coming for one of these two wrestlers.
That's the end of the first.
There's nothing right there. Heading to the second period of the last match of the day. Match between Tyler Losick.
John Needham starting on bottom. He's broken down.
Position once again into the match with 1:30 left in the second period. Running a little high, maybe Needham can. That's going to be called a stalemate. It's a reset. It's 0-0 match for Needham.
Caution. This is a. To get their team better, they need to eliminate those really.
Their coach can't be happy about all this.
Yeah.
Needham getting out with a 1-0 lead. And at least there's some points on the board. Looks like they butt it a second. Seems like they're both perfectly fine. There's a shot by Needham.
Oh,
looks like he went out of bounds.
If he kept driving, this had it right there.
Needham taking notes from Luke. The way that Roth has been handling this double leg. Look at him as an example.
Move, that we call the blast double. Just that.
For the record, fits of this Redhawks squad.
Yeah, health teacher too.
As for entry.
Starting in the neutral position still.
It'll be 0-0. Excuse me, the time is at 0. Needham up 1, third period. Down. We'll go down. Some points.
Losick putting in the legs. Come over.
Leslie's trying to make this. Could see a potential stalling call coming from him.
Out of there. You can tell that he's trying to work the leg.
Close has got a good grip, but he's nothing doing. He's riding high. I just think he should just let takedown. Needham's got the leg. And he gets out. That's 1 point for John Needham. Dick needs a takedown to tie the match. No one has a takedown so far this match.
1 minute. Injury timeout.
You're not looking too well.
Look at his shoulder.
Certainly not been a good night for Central. Sin. Now an injury to them. Lot that they should win. Not getting the points that they need. With his unsportsmanlike conduct called. I mean, as a coach, I know you control your emotions on the mat. I think coach already knows that he was. But why cost the team a point and score, but it just really doesn't set a good example for his wrestler.
He really wants the refs to make the right calls. So, and since that match, the refs have been making better calls, those locked hands. So it.
Well, I mean, it's not like the refs choked.
Yeah.
There, I heard it from here. A lot of bounce.
Almost getting his two. Get it.
He even trying to see it get aggressive to a takedown. He doesn't have it. As for in order to tie this match. Need him trying to finish.
The stalling call was on a
take down here. Things not looking too good.
Him just tying up, trying to hold it. And Needham wins 2-0.
But as for the Naperville Central Sprawl, as they lose the duel, they're a lot closer than the last three wrestlers. Cassiope, Steven,
But the varsity team really needs to get off on a very good streak. They need to get more pins and more wins.
And so for watching this broadcast, I'm ready. Thank you and have a good night.
Thank you.